Welcome back, everybody, here to your coverage of the D2CL lower bracket final as we are seeing who go up against LGD in the next round. It is Invictus Gaming up against EHOME. Let's go directly to the draft because it is already underway, and I can welcome in my co-caster for our series today. It is the wonderful and intelligent and very informative Sebastian, but I feel he's a little bit overrated.
Of course I'm overrated. I've always been overrated, and I will always be overrated.
You know, Frankfurt's coming back again soon.
Yeah.
It's coming, man.
Nice. Yeah.
And hopefully you're probably going to be playing it.
Yeah. We're one game away, so that's good. That's good. But yeah, I'm really hyped for that second game. I really like in a best of three when the underdog, actually, it's really weird to call EHOME underdogs, right? I mean, you have ROTK, Lanham, Inflame, they have sick players, but whatever. Uh-huh. They were underdogs versus IG, and they won the first map, so
it didn't really
forward.
Feel confirmed, though. Like, we have to remember that fight that EHOME decided to take underneath the tier 2 tower, jumping onto Ferrari in the manner that they did. So, for me, even if we are looking at a 10k golden experience advantage and every initiation looks to be right for one team, I still don't want to give any team the benefit of the doubt saying that they've got the victory. Because it just doesn't look to be the case.
There was a lot of mistakes done last game, I think, in the fights. I'm not saying they played bad. They all played really well, but it was really hard fights to take and really hard to... The fights were very even, so it's really hard to assess if you can actually commit or not, and they were pressured. That burning jump also on the sniper illusion, you know, the replicate, although the real sniper used shrapnel, he still used BKB and Abyssal on an illusion in the crucial Roche fight. I mean, all those moves actually hurt them a lot. But it was very even, and it's a best of three, so I think both teams... Obviously, EHOME is happy with the win, but I'm pretty sure IG is like, whatever. Let's reset and let's win the two next games, which they can do if they want to. So, and if they play well enough. So, let's see what happens now with the draft. We get a sniper ban from IG, a respect ban. I don't think sniper was that big of a deal for them last game, but sniper Radiant is definitely scary. So,
it was
good ban.
For EHOME, it was more about their combination and the morphling. He really came into his own.
Definitely. He did.
I'm surprised Invictus Gaming were willing to give the remaining morphling such room to farm too. Because where were the early rotation ganks? I know we were talking about their timing. It took 10 minutes before you went for a gank. You waited for the Axe Blink Reserve Dagger. Time. Maybe the VS and Lina could have forced the issue in another lane, because you already won your mid lane, because Ferrari basically curb stomped EHOME's mid. That sniper he had nothing.
No, he had nothing. But you know, it's a bit of what sniper does to you. You're always afraid of that sniper actually snowboarding and actually getting something. So you want to invest a lot to shut him down, and he's also such an easy kill, right? So it gives a lot of space to the other cores, and that's why when you pick sniper, you want to have something that punishes them heavily from going to on the sniper and investing all they have to actually chase him down in the fight. And Morphling definitely paid off. If you look at the Morphling's game, it was the dream game. In the first fight, he was able to do whatever he wanted. And because they had to go get that sniper at the end, very end of the fights, like back there just dishing out damage. So well, that's why the Morphling pick worked, in my opinion, as well. Back to the bans here, we have the classic Ferrari Storm ban. It's banned almost every game, so that's interesting. Oh, that's a nice pickup. So yeah, they banned the Morphling and the Storm and the Troll, very, very standard for those Chinese games. The Sniper ban, obviously, Sniper Radiant, very scary. First pick, Batrider, very solid first pick, especially because they banned the Venge, themselves, so the main Batrider counter is out, so... Mm-hmm. Then they insta get SF on Raiden, very, very strong. He can power farm very fast, and he's very safe on that lane. And just because of how the map is, Lion is a very solid support pick for them. And then they went into the AA instantly, so that's a bit surprising. Obviously, Batrider AA is good. It's a good global ganking presence. Mm-hmm. Also, decent team fight, right? You're just lasso into that. The thing with the bat is that whenever you open the fight and lasso someone, they kind of have to gather. Because at least they're going to run towards that guy if they want to save him. So they're going to gather in a way or another. That's why those counter initiation AoE spells are really good with Batrider. Magnus Batyodor is very, very scary, for example. You just lasso someone and you don't want to save him because you know that Magnus is just waiting for you to walk up to that guy and RP you. AA, in a way, is the same. He can just get very good ulti off. 10 seconds remaining. Very good ultis off. I'm just surprised about that Viper pick. I think it's... they try to shut down the SF mid or what?
Yeah, but it's something which they play with Inflame as a mid solo. Like if this was okay. EHOME, in fact, I think my notes actually say for EHOME that we would look towards the off lane.
Yeah.
For that Viper, but that was in a different combination. Actually, no, that was something else. No, I take that one completely back. Ignore that last. That's not part of my notes. But as far as the Viper, yeah, it should be... normally it's played by Inflame in the mid, but over on IG... I actually don't have a record of it.
Invictus Gaming.
Well,
I've only got it for EHOME, in fact.
I do think that Viper is good versus SF in a pure one-on-one. But from my experiences, I can recall an official match that we played and that went quite wrong because of that Viper pick. It's like, if they invest enough resources to actually give SF a good start and shut down the Viper, it could be a gank and kill the Viper. It could just be a support sitting there and just making sure SF gets all the first last hits. Then the lane, it becomes quite hard for the Viper. He doesn't have that comeback mechanism where he can... If he's losing the lane, then he can come back. If he's losing the lane, it's going to be a disaster. And you don't want your Viper to lose his lane. It's... I don't want to say all the hero does, but a big part of what the hero does is actually win his lane. If he doesn't, then the game plan is a bit different and a bit harder for the Viper. I really like the... Oh, okay, that's interesting. I really like the next pickup versus all the three first heroes IG has. It's very, very scary. Play versus Cynix.
But and, I'm a little bit more scared for EHOME. They're just going to tail off here.
Yeah.
Like, they were right with their final ban to take out that Dro range because IG has been picking up Dro. Even without having heroes to gain an advantage from the Dro, they've still been getting it because you're able to force down the towers really early on. And in combination with someone like a Shadow Shaman, all the tier 1 towers should be removed. So IG, Chuan, he's got to move. The second he gets the Mass Serpent wards up, tower must drop or Roshan must drop because IG are playing over on that Dire side. So you have to keep your eyes peeled for that one. But I'm really concerned that this Nyx Assassin is not really going to achieve anything in time. Sure, on paper, he's great up against these heroes, but IG could just weather the storm and just take out building after building. Where is this counter push coming? You got to survive a build, but where's the counter push?
Yeah, but they have a very solid lineup in a way that they can just push towers, and it's very scary to go into them. Like, if you want to go on that lineup, you need to go into a Viper that's really tanky. You need to go into Rasta wards, into a Luna, and an AA ult is going to hit you, and if you don't do anything, they're pushing towers, and if you try to defend and you don't do it well, then Bat is going to get a pick-off, and then they keep on snowballing. It's funny, because I remember I drafted the almost exact same lineup. I mean, we had Viper, Luna, Bat, and some supports as well, and we lost really hard, actually, just because the opponent was able to shut down the Viper completely. So I think in that game, they should be... EHOME should be looking to shut down the Viper, because if they don't have that very tanky frontliner, then the whole strategy falls apart completely with that IG pick. So the problem with that Abaddon pick is that they can't pressure the mid lane so much. And I'm going to be looking at that mid lane a lot. That SF versus Viper matchup is going to decide, I think, maybe not the game, but it's going to decide a lot.
Well, I can look at it as well now. We just had to have our quick disconnect pre-connect in. Find out better pathing into the server as we'll get underway. Let's get ourselves a little bit of a bearing. So ROTK is going to be the Nyx Assassin up on the top lane. That'll give your mid solo. It will be in flame eventually. For now, he will be playing that SF looking towards the bottom rune. But ZYF on the Juggernaut down the bottom. Lanham supporting as the line, and puts DDC as the last one on the Abaddon. And they're all going to meet each other.
Nice,
so
fight.
Let's just talk about this one to start with. Faith, well, is he going to go for the Chilling Touch bonus? Burning's already here with the Aura bonus.
There
it is with the Chilling Touch. DDC. Oh, that's a lot for the three man impale. But it's Inflame who's locked the Shadow Fiend. The worst that EHOME could have asked for. The Bounty Rune was at least picked up by him.
They need to buy him a TP.
But IG are now into a position where... Okay, are they going to? Is any? Yeah, they did.
Yeah, they did it.
He had to drop his tangos to pick that up, though. It's only one of the shared tangos, so it's okay.
It's actually not so bad for the SF. He got the bounty rune. I mean, for him, it's not so bad, actually.
For EHOME safe lane, because now IG's like, well, we got first blood, we can just keep going. They're running an aggro trial lane with a Luna.
Yeah, it's really good that they got the first blood, obviously, but actually SF gets a bounty and it's gonna help him a bit mid, so it's actually not so bad. I was like, what is he doing? But then it's alright. Let's see. Yeah, they're going aggressive. That's interesting. They have the Abaddon, but you know, Abaddon is actually quite bad versus heavy damage lanes. So I, when you draft Abaddon, you usually want to ban, and you want to go aggro with it, you want to ban AA and you want to ban Luna. Both of them actually fix the what Abaddon brings to lane, and now they have Luna and AA. So I think that lane bottom is not gonna go well for EHOME. And I know when you have Abaddon, you feel safe tri-laning versus tri-lane. But in that case, I think they're gonna get destroyed. So they need to get something out of the map. And you can see Lanham is already gonna roam, and I think it's a good decision. That Juggernaut's gonna get nothing.
Yeah. Well, what's he gonna do? Like, he's not even concerned about getting shackled up by Chuan, because, like, he's got spin. Like, that's normally been Juggernaut's bread and butter for getting out of really tight situations. I'm magic immune from level one. It's like watching a live stealer running around.
Yeah, it's more like he's gonna get rag kicked down. Yeah, exactly. There's nothing he can do. He's just gonna get harassed, and then they're gonna push him back. And eventually, if he overextends, they're gonna kill him. So he's just gonna try to get some farm under the tower. What IG should do is just block that camp. Like, if they don't pull, then he's gonna have zero CS. If they pull, he's gonna get some neutrals and one or two creeps under the tower, and eventually he's gonna get phase boots, and he's gonna do stuff. But if they block that pull and they sit on the lane for a few minutes, Juggernaut's gonna get nothing. And by the time Luna has four threads, let's say, they can afford to move a support. But I like what they're doing. They wanna get a kill mid. It's not an easy one, but if they can get it, it's huge.
I don't know exactly how you're meant to get it with just the Aphotic Shield, however.
They could. Look at Fury's positioning. It's quite bad for now.
Body block from DDC. Body block. That's going to help him. Let's the Earthspike come. Nah. TP support's coming in from the Shaman very quickly, but Ferrari, he's just so tanky. He walks himself away.
Yeah, good TP. Good TP from Chuan. I mean, that level 1 Lion, unfortunately for them, it doesn't do much. He has a second stun, so it's you can't even land two raises. You have to land, unless your positioning is perfect. But yeah, since the Viper was walking back, he couldn't. I mean, SF is not doing so well, actually. Ferrari is dominating him again, like, really hard. So, a bit scary for that SF. The lanes are going really well for IG right now, in my opinion. Let's take a look on that top lane. I haven't watched at all. What?
Well, the first time I looked up here, it was just Luo throwing out the Firefly and trying to push the creep wave back onto the T1 tower so ROTK would lose balance. And then he went farming inside the jungle, and that gave him enough money to now afford up the bottle. So he's looking quite comfortable with the, but ROTK still found a lot of
but
CS
he
up here.
Has a death on the bat?
Wait, what? Did? Okay, we both missed that?
Oh, he died to a neutral.
Oh yeah, Batrider dies to a neutral creep.
Okay, I didn't see that. That's maybe why he's a bit on the farm.
Because Nyx is winning the lane. Intentional. I think I know it was intentional. It had to be
okay.
Intentional.
Alright.
Just to get back, because he would have purchased the bottle. I remember when I saw him, because he had enough money just shy of it to buy the bottle. It was farming up the camp, and he would have bought a bottle and a TP scroll to come back to the lane. I'm
okay,
almost positive.
Then it makes sense. I like the decision from front to move around. I mean, bottom lane is under control. The Luna is farming really well. The Juggernaut is completely shut down. Now he wants to bring something. He has Bassie and whatever. He has nothing. He just has Boots and Bassie. And then they can afford to have that Rasta move around. He smoked himself mid. They want to get a kill on the SF. This could happen. If Inflame isn't careful, the next time he walks up to the creeps, he's going to die.
He's not walking up. He need to walk further up north to make that happen.
The Courier is going to die.
Yep. That's probably worth more, considering it also had the Ring of Vasilius on it. Plus,
that
now
was
you
the
got
Juggernaut
three minutes without
just
it.
Right-clicking the Courier and not being careful.
Lanham.
Oh, that's a
that's a lot of sticky napalm. The Shadow Fiend's still going to end up dying in the mid. I'm going to stick with Luo now up on the top.
Nice,
of Chuan.
Nice
coming in with a shock. RTK, he's still got the shackles.
Well,
and then where's the Spike Carapace? He never turned it on while sitting inside the Firefly, allowing Batrider to find his kill. And Shadow Fiend, he actually died behind the tower in mid.
Yeah,
you see what happened?
Yeah, he just got Viper Strike, sorry. And he just died to the poison. It's just, his positioning wasn't so good, and he just, maybe he had a Baron behind him, so he was like, I can probably survive, but then he just died to the Viper right clicks plus poison attacks, and yeah, unfortunate. I mean, Viper is destroying mid again. Ferrari, look at the Viper, he's level 7, the SF is level 4, I don't even know how you come back from this. Like, He wants to get his level 5 and then he wants to go jungle. But that Viper, like, that pick is working really well for IG, and it's really nice that they were able to protect the Viper from that initial gank. It would have done a lot. And now he has 4 threats. SF is in, like, I can't even emphasize in how, like, this SF is gonna get destroyed all game long, honestly.
Yeah. Unless someone's gonna massively stack for him, but Juggernaut's been forced into his portion of the jungle so much that they don't have any stacks over on the side. Maybe this could help. Nope. Faith's not gonna give him anything.
Yeah, they stacked the bit camp 3 times already. I mean, 2 times, so it's a triple camp. So that's already something. But I mean, he needs levels.
Enough to repair the difference between him and Ferrari.
That poor guy, man. He's not even level 5, like.
Is this going to be like one of the situations from the last game? Like, well, the only hope we have is to get first blood, obviously not possible now, over on the Shadow Fiend, and then he just gets a lot more space. Because Ferrari, you're not going to get a kill on him. In fact, Ferrari is just going all out.
He's
going to
kill him.
Pushing him back. Is he going to Viper Strike this too? DDC's there to help him out, though. And Ferrari is
playing really well. He's playing really well. He's applying the pressure he needs to apply. And look at this. He's forcing Lion plus Abba to be there. So that Luna is completely uncontested. He can do whatever he wants. And he's never going to be afraid to die. That Juggernaut is still getting nothing. So they're losing all the lanes. ROTK is doing decent. I mean, he has mana boots on the Nyx. But what is he going to achieve? Like, he can't kill anyone. I know. Yeah, the lanes are... Yeah, it's looking very, very, very grim.
Batrai's gonna have an 8-minute blink dagger.
It's gonna be... IG has... They have what they need to destroy EHOME completely, you know. Like, the start that they have is the dream start. So let's see how they can use that. They have a very good rushing lineup with the Luna. You always have a rushing lineup when you have Luna.
Sorry.
Oh my god.
I'm just watching Benny Hill moment up on top lane. Lana's gonna die to this impact!
Oh my god.
They didn't look! We're still at the end of the night time, and they thought the Chuan ran down into either this little crevice or down to this one, and they just took so much damage with the Lion. Chuan, now he's still got 2 stick charges, he's moving up and down to try and dodge that Impale coming in from Abaddon.
That solo kill for the Rast that was so big. It's gonna give him his mana boots plus his level 6, so... unfortunate. What is SF up to? He's level 6, he cleared the stack.
He's
so
dead.
Lua's
gonna lasso him and drag him back down again, so then Vernon can follow up with a high level Lucid Beam. And then Batrider's Flame Break to finish the job. So that's what he's up to right now.
Yeah, and this is when it gets out of control, because now they're gonna take over their jungle. They have the Battle Dagger, so he's gonna be very afraid of walking up anywhere. They dewarded. This is perfect play from IG so far, honestly. It's just perfect. They have to be a bit afraid of the Nyx being there and try to get kills or counter go on them. So they need some sentries, they already have some on Faith. So, yep, they're gonna be looking to push that bottom tower. It shouldn't be too hard. He's just gonna creep skip with the Batrider, good decision. And Shuan is just getting level stop. He can TP bottom eventually if he has to, but I don't really think he is.
They just got a glimpse of Juggernaut. Well, you don't have Lasso, Ferrari here. There goes your spear, but he's happy to Viper Strike him because there is just no running away from this one. Even with the Hex support, the Sticky Napalm up and one more attack. And there it's going to be. Nope. Yeah, okay, Blink Dagger in. There it's going to be. Revenge kill. He doesn't have another disable, but Luo is still taking so much damage from the tower. It's allowed him to get one pick off, and maybe now even into Ferrari. And Victus Gaming going a little bit too deep at the moment.
If they chase, they're gonna die here.
They're chasing. And the Eclipse, it just burns them. Faith, the Rays in flames coming in. That Impel stun from RTK is gonna be on target. Ferrari with a TP out. And an early Drom's arriving for Burning. We'll get the movement Radiant speed to both Faith as well as Burning to get back to the T1 tower safely. They only ended up losing the Batrider.
It's okay. They only lost an Abaddon, so it wasn't too bad. And he got the target up, actually. That's not okay. Every kill EHOME can get at this point is a good kill. Your Lion got one level from that Batrider kill. If he gets level 6, then he can maybe burst that AA or Rasta by himself. Even the Luna could die. So this is, you know, IG now they need to make the right decisions. They took the bottom safely in tower, but that jungle isn't so safe because EHOME is so far behind that if they need to invest 5 heroes to farm their jungle and protect it, they're gonna invest 5 heroes. And IG, you don't wanna let top lane completely abandoned, so they might just have to sack the jungle of EHOME and just, you know, go back to farm a bit. or keep on pressuring. Yeah, that's a good move as well. They're smoking behind the tower.
In flame, yeah, DDC is the primary target. They do
he's
not want to have
just
that.
Level six.
Well, he's got the level 6, but can he still survive this one? The flame break's trying to keep him in close. He does get the shield up, but with the slows coming out from Ferrari, and everyone having 2 points up in that aura, it's helping out. The Juggernaut jumping, Mount Ferrari's going to go down. And EHOME at the opening with a Finger of Death arriving for Lanham. He's able to nuke down the Ancient Apparition, and RTK, he's able to find Luo, but he's got no follow-up stun. Even with that one stick charge he's got, it's not enough to give him the impale.
Yeah, that was really good kills. Like, that Viper kill was so big. But I said he was level 6 because he just turned level 6 half a second before they go for him. I think they decided to go for the Abaddon just because he was level 5 and it was a safe kill, but then one creep died and gave him level 6, so it gave them a few like extra seconds to actually get the kills, and it gave time for Lion and Nyx to wrap around. Good kills on the AA and the Viper, the target gun regardless, but it's good. EHOME is getting some kills that they need those kills, they need XP.
The problem is they're losing all their map. This is something which I saw LGD do. I was actually casting one of the games from our earlier qualifier, and I think it was LGD that did it. But I think it was actually something that Mineski did during an MLG Pro League game. And all they did was they just they power leveled a Shadow Shaman, and then it was tower after tower after tower. It didn't matter if they lost their tier 2s, their tier 3s, they just kept taking racks after racks, and moving as a 5-ball to make it happen. The difference is with this IG 5-ball, you've got already a huge amount of damage increase from both the Blessing as well as the Chilling Touch. But your control factors from the Batrider and the Viper make it even scarier. Shadow Shaman, he's got a lot of burst damage with the 4 points up and Aether Shock. That's going to drop Lion to half, if not less, of his HP at the very, very start. And Abaddon, he will go below half of his HP. So this is what your problem is. So they won't care right now, IG, losing a tier 1 tower on top lane. Like, it happens.
Yeah,
but they'll take the tier 2 tower in mid.
Yeah, it's a snowball death too. But I mean, I think that Abaddon pick is a big factor in why... it does a lot for IG, actually. It doesn't do anything for EHOME, because Abaddon wants to fight, but you don't want to fight this lane up anyway. They have better lanes, they're gonna get Roche, they're gonna push, they're gonna get advantage, better items, and they're just gonna keep on pushing. So what you want to do in that case is having...
Spike Carapace screws around with Luo, but he still managed to get the hold on the Juggernaut. He does Dragon Back so far, he doesn't get hit by that Ice Blast, but it doesn't matter. They kept with the Shackle, so there was no Omni Slash timing available there to the Juggernaut, and now the push will come to the tier 2.
I think EHOME should be a bit more clear about if they want to defend or not. Like, they're wasting time, you know. This Juggernaut should be farming somewhere else. He needs to catch up. There's no point for him being there. I don't think they want to fight. They have Aegis, they have, like, there's no way they can fight this. They
have high ground.
Yeah, they're gonna end the game right now, but they don't have any outpush potential. I mean, I think EHOME is heavily outpushed, honestly. It's really hard for them to do anything, and that Abaddon doesn't do anything.
So the Mass Serpent Wards are now down for Chuan. They only just came up without moving up to the high ground.
They don't have a creep wave, it's coming.
Yeah, but they still have the catapult. Look at the damage onto the Juggernaut. That was just started up by Ferrari, and then the Lucid Beam came in. Ice Blast, gonna be in a half decent position. They did still lose the Viper, but with the Aegis model being the only thing they really lose from that, I think there's a problem when you've managed to take also 2/3 away of that HP from the tower.
Yeah,
that's perfectly
alright.
They're gonna
push them back. They can stay. I think they should stay. They use Eclipse, sure. It might be a bit scary. Oh my god,
that's
mistake.
A problem. That's a real problem.
That
EDC doesn't have ulti either, so they want to be cautious about this one. And Inflame, he's gonna get ulti down by Ferrari. And well, where's that Shadow Fiend? The Requiem of Souls will burst out. Luo, not in the greatest position here. Gonna get Omni slashed, isolated from the rest of his team. So all three slashes connected onto Luo. And Faith, what are you doing? He wants to body block Ferrari for a moment, and now the spin. The Juggernaut's hot in his tail. And he's got the extra stun to help out from Lanham. So Ferrari will die here. And Invictus Gaming, they overcommit themselves that inch too far.
Are they gonna back? Yeah, they are. They don't know where Luna and the others are. That was a good buyback. I think they should just focus buildings. I don't think they should go for the kills behind the towers and force the buybacks and everything. I think they should just focus on hitting the tower. Maybe get a good lasso if they can. But I think they try to go for kills a bit too much, and then they eat a lot of damage, and eventually with the buyback, oh, that SF is in trouble. Yeah. The ult is just gonna die.
Burning has been waiting until this ice blast come off cooldown, so he could just do that. That's all he wanted to do. One lucid beam is all he wanted, just a quick pick off, and he was hanging around three players before, and for some reason, the message didn't reach the Juggernaut that Burning was in the neighborhood. Maybe he thought he was gonna back himself out of here, but the Batrider is hot on the tail. One more lucid beam, it's a double kill for Burning.
Yeah, those kills are crucial, because they're just getting a bit of farm after the space they created at the bottom, and all that farm is actually negated. They have the mech on the left.
This is almost a time when you almost want a five-man group up push mid. The Arcane Brew is off cooldown for Shaman in the middle, the Shadow Shaman wards will then be up. Ice Blast, you can't use that too, and in fact there's a regeneration rune.
Somehow that Lion has more net worth than the Juggernaut. I don't even know how that Lion got dagger plus that stuff, but whatever. Lanim is actually farm. He's actually having a good game, Lion, somehow.
That farm is still going to achieve very, very little. And yeah, I feel like most of it probably came in from his Finger of Death kill secures.
Yeah. And they have the mech on SF. I like this decision. It's going to help them take some uphill fights. I think if IG... IG just focus on taking down the tower, then they can relax. They maybe want to wait for next rush right now. The dagger on the Rasta is very big. That's a very good news for them. I don't know what Burning went for. He spent his gold. He went for what it is. Okay, it's Nogger. Oh, he's actually not that farm, right? What does he have?
I think
he had more gold than this.
Wait, yeah, that's Ferrari's. There's a minus for Faith. There's...
Oh, there's a Mithril Hammer on the ground in base. That's why. I was like, that's weird. He almost has a BKB.
Okay, yeah. I was with you. I'm like, there's no way he's only got Noga Club at 17 minutes into the game.
Yeah,
with,
like,
or,
what if, yeah, exactly.
Hasn't died, got 5 assists, got 2 kills. Yeah, that should all be perfect for him.
Yeah. No, now he has he's working on a BKB soon. AeroTK is looking for kills. I think it's just scouting, right? Or actually, they are smoked with a Juggernaut. But that Juggernaut is trying to do way too much. He should just farm.
They're going to go for the kill on the Faith. But that's like the most useless kill they can get. He's still
through
the Ice Blast out. Wasn't enough for Chuan. He's already got his Blink Dagger up. So Lanham, he's going to lose his life for this. So you've just lost your Lion for an Ancient Apparition. You spent all his money because he already owns his Hand of Midas. He bought that. In fact, he had that purchase 30 seconds before they even ganked him.
Yeah, he did. He did, so didn't do so much, but I mean, I really wanted to see that Juggernaut farming, honestly. He's level 9. You need to just sit and farm lanes right now. They don't even have so much killing, but I mean, now with the Rasta Dagger, they do. You can just farm Ancients, try to get this farm up, at least get the Mask of Madness.
Well, RTK, you want to keep things secret? Don't Vendetta on top of a Dire Observer ward.
It's good. It's okay that he keeps on scouting them. I think he has to create space somehow, and they're going for the Juggernaut instantly. Maybe that's why he's not farming. They won't give him a break.
There's just no space to be had. Wow! Whoa! Really? Really?
Yeah, that's a lot of hate, but it's still worth it. I mean, he's getting nothing.
But Mass
Serpent
Wards.
He actually bought the recipe.
You actually committed your Mass Serpent Wards.
Yeah, it's okay. I mean, they don't want to push in, and Rosh is in back. But they just want to chin, I know.
Yep. Okay, that's
It's alright.
Okay, I also looked at and realized after he went for the Ramning, then that he didn't have Radiant's enough mana to follow up with anything else, because he committed everything to the bottom.
Oh, alright. Burning has the BKB now. Midas on AA. That Viper is gonna go for a Man Tower. Maybe it could be an SNY. It's not so bad here. He just needs to tank up, so... Okay. I mean, EHOME is getting a bit of farm, but it's far from enough. That second rush is gonna be scary.
Yeah.
Oh, that could be good. No, okay, they back off. Never mind. They're not gonna get kills here. AeroTK was around.
Even if you thought you might, when you got Blink Dagger and 4 stuff over on Luo, even if he's gotta save his own teammates, he can do it that way. And if you try and fight around the Roshan area, you could just find yourself getting lassoed onto the high ground. And every single hero apart from, Juggernaut would have a way to get down, and that's only if someone walks point-blank range on the hill, so he can Omni-Slash. You will
And the Gem. The Gem also on the bat is scary. They still did not deward. I mean, the good thing for EHOME is that IG is not taking over their jungle. So they have ward there. They're getting a bit of farm. You can see the EHOME jungle is always getting farmed. Or it has been for the last 2 or 3 minutes, so that's a good sign for them. They're getting a... some farm going their way. That SF, look at the SF, he's getting a BKB, so I mean, he caught up.
He's actually top net worth now.
Yeah, it's good. He's just been farming. I wouldn't say it's enough, but they gave him a lot of space for sure. They went for the Juggernaut over and over again. And yeah, it's... Oh, is he getting Chuan? Sort of.
Yeah,
no.
With a blink in, but then again, it's a turnaround. RTK just gets snapped. It really did look like Chuan was going to die with the Urn Charge as well.
They were ready for this.
Support was there.
Yeah, they were ready for this, unfortunate. But again, he's creating a bit of space. SF is going to have his BKB. So they have to last with the SF, but again, they have that shield. But you know, Abba is not the best counter versus Pat because the range of the shield is actually so small. And with the 4 staff, if Pat is quick enough, it's really hard to get in. They want to go for the Juggernaut, but they have the rest of there.
Okay,
he's
just been ganked twice, 3 times on bottom lane. Now, again, as well. He actually bounces in a ramp form.
But he can turn.
No. The flame break from Luo bought enough time.
Too much damage. Alright, so Juggernaut died again. Did he buy anything? No, he didn't. But, I mean, there's nothing to buy at this stage. He's so far behind. And when Rosh is back, they're gonna get the tower, probably back off and get Rosh after. Which is good for them. SF BKB. I think they could even hold. Maybe they can defend, actually. They don't have Rest Award. They don't have Lasso.
Yeah.
No, there's your jump in. Already burning, turned into a chicken. The four star's gonna keep him away from the Requiem Assaults, allowing some of the BKB and then into your Eclipse Gullet. The damage bounce out. It's burning. He tanked the entire Omni Slash, but they've walked all the way back so far. They're in range of the Mass Serpent Wards that were used before to kill off that Jugger. And Inflame lassoed up. The Ice Blast doing his work. It's a 2-for-1 trade off at the moment. As the rest of EHOME will be retreating. Or will they? They turn around, the Spire Carapace gonna stop Luo from running away here. They have enough stuns, they bounce him twice on the Impale as well as the Earth Spike. So they're able to get a double kill into RNTK. But you've just lost your SF and your Juggernaut for that.
EHOME is fighting decent. I think EHOME is fighting quite well, to be honest. It's really hard fights to take. They played it well. It's really unfortunate that they didn't get Burning. It's so unfortunate. If you would have died here, then the fight would have been completely different. Also, Lanham held up to his ulti. He tried to wait, burning his BKB and get a kill. And then he did a news finger, which was a bit of a mistake in my opinion. But still, I think it's a decent trade for EHOME. IG was very patient with the last one.
I think you have to have a closer look at the Juggernaut, man, because that was a dieback.
Oh, he bought back?
He actually bought back and died. If you look at the net worth he's sub 5,000. 23 minutes in.
That's a disaster. I don't think I've seen a Juggernaut that's that on the farm, honestly.
He's a 0-6-4 Juggernaut.
Yeah, he has nothing. Like, he really had nothing. I don't even know how you come back in that game. And it's a really difficult Juggernaut game. It's not even an easy one. Like, Viper is actually very annoying. It's a Juggernaut.
And when you've got that much of nothing, like, you need to have the bodyguard. That's the only way you're going to come back again.
Boy. And Viper went for the Manta style, which is good. More tankiness against Juggernaut, and it's not that
it kind
really
of screws
need a lot
with his Omni Slash. I still couldn't believe how much of that Omni Slash to connect him on Burning.
Yeah.
Like, the RNG gods were there with the Juggernaut that time around.
But yeah, it was a really nice one, right? But he escaped with a few HP, and then he earned himself, or I'm not sure what happened, and then he came back in the fight. So yeah, it's a tough game for the EHOME squad, but you know, RTK is doing a lot of work with his Nyx in the fights. He got a really nice impale off, now he's gonna have a 4 staff. They got the gem from the bat, which is good for them. Get some map control back.
The only downside is they pick up all of these items, but they still need to keep on finding kills. They need to find openings, because Faith is now just over 2,000 gold away from his Aghanim Scepter, and Shadow Shaman's building into his Aghanim Scepter. And the ganking potential from IG has already been pretty effective. But if you get an Aghanim Scepter over on this Shadow Shaman, pushing high ground could be forced by IG. They won't have to wait for the perfect position, the perfect timing, catching somebody out and then going high ground. They can just go. In fact, I think they can do it already.
He can solo kill the Juggernaut if he gets Aghs on the rest. So that's a good thing for him. I think they're going to try to end the game now, but they're not pushing. Yeah, they are pushing bottom lane. He got an illusion on Burning. Yeah, they could finish the game, you know. It's good, they're dewarding this to make sure the bat can actually get there.
Well, they know with the Mass Serpent what's going down this time. Well, there is a fortification, but they should be able to at least remove the tower and maybe the rain tracks.
Yeah. Yeah, they, I think they can rex, definitely, but they think they need to, like, just kill the tower. They shouldn't go too deep, or... Because they have good defense, they have good team fight, EHOME. They just have to focus on getting the tower down, and everything's gonna be fine. They can really slow siege, they don't have to rush anything.
Juggernaut will add some level of pressure on that top lane.
Yeah. I like EHOME's positioning. Dire's structures, I think it's a smart positioning. They know it's hard for IG to dive.
Yep. And they don't want to throw that ice blast at the top lane like they did previously, because they want to have that for when they take the fight. Just like now, ice blast.
No, they need to grab
it's flying
that
in. It's gonna hit perfectly on DDC, so he cannot regenerate inside of here. Sitting very low. Luo unable to find the big opening, but it's gonna get finger of death down. Yeah, he will still lose the Abaddon. As Inflame gonna get rammed, and Ferrari is gonna put him back in the pen. One more attack, and that's gonna do the job. So the buyback coming in from ROTK. The Mass Serpent Wards, a lot of them were lost, but Luna doesn't really care because now you're able to let her attack, or will she? With the buyback from SF, IG will care. They're backing out of here. Lanham jumps in for the first stun. Ferrari out of mana.
Much, yeah.
And they're not gonna get the following stun on from ROTK to Ferrari.
They don't have BKB on SF, but they wanna back off, fair enough.
It feels more like safety first. Wait until the Mass Serpent Wards are up and go again. You've got another
very safe.
3 minutes and a bit left over on the Aegis of the Immortal. You're under no pressure.
Yeah, I mean, IG is playing that super safe. They could have tried to force a bit, but yet again, they're one game down. It's a best of three. If they, like, if somehow they fail and they give back the advantage, they can lose the game. Like, it's good to play like this. They got two buybacks, right? They got the SF and the Nyx, so that's a lot of gold denied. IG still have everything they need. They need to go back there as fast as possible, just to be able to use that Aegis advantage. I think they will, and probably Rax the next time. But again, for EHOME, even if they lose Rax, it doesn't mean anything. It's gonna reduce a bit of the farm. It's gonna, you know, mess with the lane equilibriums, but. Losing that Rex is not that big. They can't afford to lose the game on that Rex. Better not defend it if they feel like there's no way they can even the fight.
We'll see what their choice is going to be shortly. For now, Juggernaut is just happy they're not killing him. Able to farm quickly up on this top lane. While Ferrari's being stalked by the Nyx Assassin. It was just instead of Vendetta Mana Burn, blinked himself away. Doesn't want to get involved in anything in case there was support. And coming in like it is now, like Sean is going to arrive on this bottom lane.
I feel like during all this time, this Juggernaut, if he was just farming in the enemy's jungle, split pushing, he would have got so much gold. That hero farms so fast, but he's really poor.
He did start the split push, like he was trying to beat into the tier 2 tower when they were pushing
on him. But I think it was a bit late, because honestly, his net worth is below the Shadow Shaman net worth. And IG is not running a heavy ganking lineup. They've been 5-manning a lot. So, yeah, I don't know. He definitely needs to keep on. I think, yeah, here it's good. He shouldn't even TP. He shouldn't TP. He should just let the racks fall and keep on farming. He needs farm, else he's never going to be able to do anything in this game. I think they're going to give up this racks. I don't think they can defend. They don't have. He's porting. I don't like this.
Here comes that TP, as you said. Mass Serpent Wards are down in range of the melee, and that's going to be the primary focus. Lanham's trying to get rid of a couple of them, and Luo, he jumps out, he picks up the lion into the eclipse. There's a lot of damage being done. Three heroes on the sidelines. Inflame winding up for the big swing, but really, there's just nothing much to play with. The bouncing glaives are coming in, and it really was like you give up the bottom racks, but how do you then defend against IG? You already knew you're pushing it uphill, so it was kind of like an all or nothing in at the end.
They couldn't defend this racks for sure. I think the right approach would have been to let it go and try to defend the next one with a bit more items, but I'm not even sure that would have worked. I mean, IG had a dominating lead. It was really hard for EHOME to take any sort of defense. And the way IG played that push was interesting. They went up and Batrider was waiting, and they cleared a creep wave, and then they went with the lasso. So it's impossible to actually take the fight, because the Eclipse, like level 3 Eclipse, is gonna hit everyone. There are no creeps, so every single beam is gonna hit heroes, so it's really hard. You saw the damage output, they just all died in half a second, so... Yeah great play by IG, better laning, better pick. I think it's only the draft in that game, in my opinion.
Well, let's see how our draft goes for game number 3. We'll have ourselves a break, grab yourself a beverage, and we'll see you all back here for the final deciding game. Who will play up against LGD in our lower bracket consolation final, first game tomorrow at 10 CEST. Make sure you don't miss that one. Make sure you don't miss game number 3. We'll be back soon.